Hello, everybody, and Merry Christmas! Can you believe it? Christmas is finally here! No more wishing, no more waiting. Now it's time for celebrating. Whoa, that rhymed. Once again, we are going to light it up. But before we get started, though, I think we need to fix something, Michelle. You could use a little help with your outfit. You don't look like Christmassy enough.
No?
Let's see if I can help you.
So, oh, you got some lights for me here.
Yes, I have this and have something for your hair.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, How's that?
That's cute.
A little bit more lit up?
Yep.
Wow. This is the most fantastic Christmas outfit I have ever seen.
Yep.
In fact, I think with our lighted up headbands, it would be even better. Don't you agree? I think one of my favorite things about Christmas is the lights. They make everything look so much better. There's just one problem with them, though. It seems like they're always breaking. It's like one burns out and the entire strand stops. Then you have to check each bulb, make sure it's working. Flick a few, make sure they're not just loose, or shake the whole tree. It can be so frustrating.
Fortunately for us, during Christmas time, we can celebrate the birth of a light that never goes out. Who is that light? That's right, it's Jesus. He is called the light of the world, because he overcame the darkness of sin and shows us the way to heaven. And best of all, you don't have to check him or flick him or shake him. Jesus' light never goes out. It shines as bright today as the day he was born. And today we get to hear the story of how that light first came into the world. To get the story started, let's see if you can guess what's inside of the first present.
Teason, I don't know about you, but I love this time of year.
Me too. I love the lights, the trees, the giant parades. I love the joy I feel around the holidays. I love the snow that falls and covers the earth. I love to sing songs of the Savior's birth. Can't wait for Christmas.
You can find me in a deck of cards. And the Wizard of the Oz, the Thin Man, was missing me.
Oh.
My beat gives you life. Do you know what it is?
Three, two, one, light it up!
Joseph were in love and they planned to get married. But then one day the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and told her that God's spirit was going to be inside of her and make her pregnant with a baby. This wasn't going to be any ordinary baby though. Most babies have human dads. But this baby was going to be called the Son of God. There was only one problem with that. Joseph didn't understand that God was going to be the father. So when he found out, though, that Mary was going to have a baby and it wasn't his, he thought about calling the whole wedding off. But then an angel of God appeared to Joseph in a dream and told him that it was okay, that the baby inside of Mary was from God. He told Joseph to take Mary as his wife, and then when the baby was born, to name him Jesus. When Joseph woke up, he didn't waste any time. He and Mary got married as soon as they could. Let's see if you can guess what the next present is, okay? Here are the clues. I'm round like a ball, but if you kick me, you'll hurt your foot. I'm always spinning, but never get dizzy. I'm the third planet from the sun.
I know.
Three, two, one,
light it up.
It's the world. After Mary and Joseph got married, Caesar Augustus, the most powerful ruler in the world, said that everyone had to travel back to their hometown and be counted. For Mary and Joseph, that meant a long trip to the town of Bethlehem. Unfortunately, there were tons of other people in Bethlehem for the same reason. And because of that, all of the hotels and guest rooms were already filled. Uh-oh. The Bible doesn't say exactly where Mary and Joseph ended up staying, but we know there was a manger there. Hmm. A manger is a feeding box for animals. So that probably means that they stayed somewhere like a barn or a stable. It wasn't much, but it came just in the nick of time. Let's see what's inside of the next present. So I'm gonna read it to you. I cry when I'm sad, and when I'm hungry, and when I'm tired. If you catch me at the wrong time, I'm kind of stinky. I don't know how I'm giving you these clues. I can't even talk yet. I know what it is. Do you want to try?
Three, two, one,
light it up.
When the time finally came, baby Jesus was born. There wasn't much in the barn for Mary to work with, so she wrapped him in a cloth and laid him down in the manger. Can you believe that? Jesus, the light of the world, the King of Kings, the Son of God, wasn't born in a palace or a hospital or even a house. He was born in a dirty, stinky barn with a bunch of animals. He wasn't wrapped in expensive blankets. He was wrapped in an ordinary cloth. He wasn't laid down in a baby crib. He was put in a manger, which is a feeding box for animals. But that's exactly how God wanted it. He wanted to show the world that Jesus wasn't just a gift for fancy people who lived in fancy places. He wanted the world to know that Jesus was a gift for everyone. We have one more present. Let's see what's inside. Here are your clues. People are dying to see me. I'm a place of perfection. I rhyme with 5 plus 2. You ready?
Yes.
3, 2, 1,
light it up! Heaven. The Bible says that after Jesus was born, an angel from heaven appeared to some shepherds in a nearby field. Listen to what the angel said to the shepherds. So open your Bible to Luke chapter 2, verse 10 to 14. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. It will bring great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He's the Messiah, the Lord. Here is how you will know I'm telling you the truth. You will find a baby wrapped in a strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a large group of angels from heaven also appeared. They were praising God. They said, "May glory be given to God in the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those he's pleased with on earth." Instantly, the shepherds ran to find Mary and Joseph and the baby so that they could give glory and praise to God.
What a great story. But do you think you can remember it all from the pictures? Let's find out. We're going to show you the presents once again, and I want you to tell me what happened in that part of the story. Are you guys ready? Okay, here we go. Here's present number one. Number two, number three, and number four. Way to go, you guys. You did it.
Isn't that amazing? The first Christmas gift ever was baby Jesus, wrapped in a cloth and lying in a manger. Not only was Jesus the first Christmas gift ever, he was the best Christmas gift ever. Mm-hmm. Now, I know some of you might be thinking, is Jesus really the best gift ever? Like, I mean, he doesn't fit under my tree. I can't unwrap him or ride him down my street or download cool apps on him. How could he possibly be the best?
Okay, imagine it's early on Christmas morning and you wake up. You're the first one awake, so you run downstairs to wake everyone else up. When everyone is finally downstairs and sitting around the tree, you see it for the first time. A beautiful gift, wrapped in a beautiful gift bag. And the most beautiful name is on it. Your name. When you open it up.
When you open it up, there it is in all of its glory. The best gift you could ever imagine. A pair of socks? Wait a second. Time out. Hup, just stop it. No, socks are not so cool. Let's imagine that they're not socks, though. No way, not socks at all. They are. The Samurai 6000 Karate Chopper Mitts. You can believe it. You have wanted a Samurai 6000 Karate Chopper Mitts for as long as you can remember. And now they are all yours. You can karate chop anything you want. Boards, carts, killer bees karate chopper. You can karate chop your sister.
Oh, whoa. Maybe not your sister.
No, that's, kids, that's not a good idea. No.
For the first week, you wear those Samurai karate choppers nonstop. You even sleep in them, which is why you accidentally karate chop your bed in half during a bad dream. But then after a couple weeks, you kind of run out of things to karate chop.
That happens.
Then after a month, the karate chopping starts to kind of seem boring. Mm. Then after a year, the karate chop mitts, they're on the floor in your closet. And then after 2 years, your mom picks up the mitts and throws them in the trash because you're never going to use them anymore. The Samurai 6000 Karate Chopper Mitts were kind of a fun for a little while, but they didn't do anything important, and they didn't last forever.
Nope.
But God's gift, the gift of Jesus, is different. Let's look at our story pictures one more time to see why.
Not only do these pictures help to tell the story of Jesus' birth, they also tells us today's Bible verse. It's from John chapter 3, verse 16. So kids, can you open your Bible? We're going to read it together. Take a look. God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son. Anyone who believes in him will not die, but will have eternal life.
Jesus won't fit under your tree. You can't unwrap him, and he definitely will not karate chop your car in half. But there's one thing that Jesus can karate chop in half, and that's death. The Bible says that we all sin. That means that we all mess up and we break God's rules. The consequence for sinning is forever death and separation from God. But that's not the end of the story. On the very first Christmas morning, over 2,000 years ago, God gave us the best gift ever. He gave us Jesus. And later on, when Jesus died and rose again, it's like he karate chopped death in half. And now, if you believe in Jesus and follow him, you get to live with him forever in heaven. That is way better than anything you will ever find under a tree.
Don't get us wrong. Opening presents on Christmas Day is super fun. We know that. But we already got the best gift ever. It's Jesus. And to celebrate that gift, maybe we should do what the shepherds did when they found about Jesus. maybe we should give glory and praise to God. So let's do that right now, because He deserves all the glory.
Let's pray. Father, You do deserve all the glory. We are so thankful that You have karate chopped death for us, that You have given us eternal life with You. And Father, for that, we thank You for the greatest gift You could ever give us. So Father, we just come to You and praise You for the gift of eternal life and that You gave us Jesus. We pray this in Your name. Amen.
Amen.
Don't forget to do week 3 activity, and this week is going to be a fun one. And we will see you next week.
Yes. Merry Christmas.
Bye, guys.
Bye.